Hey, what's up, guys? Tyler here with Secure Team. Well, if you've been following the UFO community the past couple of days, you may have seen a new video that's now gone viral that was put out by my friend StreetCap1. And the video he posted, entitled Reflection in a Visor, goes on to analyze a particular photograph taken during the Apollo moon landings. When we sent men to the moon, all the astronauts had Hasselblad cameras attached to their chests so they could snap photographs on the moon. And so in one particular photograph taken during the Apollo 17 mission, we see a photo of an astronaut taking a gander, we'll just say, at some large moon rocks, okay? And so this means that another astronaut had to have taken this photo, obviously. And more often than not, you can actually see the other astronauts who are taking the photo in the visor. And so when you actually look and you zoom in into the visor of the astronaut who is being photographed, we see something very strange. And by the way, this video is just touching quickly on StreetCap's video. There's something else that I want to show you captured in some other photographs on the moon, so stay tuned for this. But as we zoom in and as StreetCap showed, is that when you look at this astronaut that is supposedly taking this photo, it almost doesn't look like an astronaut at all. It looks like a stagehand. And the strange thing about it was that, well, StreetCap pointed out, where is the large backpack on the back of the astronaut, which seems to be missing here? Now, the astronauts carry these massive life support backpacks on the moon. They're unmistakable. But in this photograph, it would seem that the backpack is basically non-existent. I mean, sure, we can see the body of the astronaut, we can see his head up top, his arms, his legs. And while this could be chalked up to simply the curvature of the visor, because these visors do warp the image because they're curved. And so it's been pointed out that this may be simple distortion that is making it look like the backpack does not exist. And in fact, if you look at the shadow of the astronaut down on the moon here, you can actually see what appears to be the outline of the backpack. And so, it's just basically how you look at it. Some of you may say, okay, this just doesn't look like an astronaut. It looks more like a stagehand wearing something that looks like a astronaut's uniform. But then again, you have distortion caused by the visor, and that may be the case here. But my question for this particular image, and what was even more odd to me and what I didn't hear anybody pointing out, was the question of how did this astronaut, which would have been the one that had to take this photograph, how did he take the photograph when he's standing at an angle that almost looks as if he's standing, looking away from the astronaut he is supposedly taking a photo of? Now, if you know anything about the Apollo moon missions and the cameras they used while they were walking around on the moon, the cameras were securely attached to the chest area of the astronauts. So, you could not remove them. It's not like they could pick these cameras up and look at them through a little peephole and take a photograph. They had no way to do this. And so what they did is they attached these cameras to the chests of these astronauts and rigged a little button that they could press that would snap a photo. Now, because they could not look through an eyepiece and actually see what they were taking a picture of, they basically just had to judge and point the camera in whatever direction they could to take the photo. But make no mistake, whatever they were photographing, they had to be standing completely facing forward. They had to be completely head on to take a photograph because, again, the cameras are secured to their chest. And so if I wanted to take a photograph of another astronaut, I had to be completely facing him so that the camera was facing him. And as you're seeing in these other Apollo photographs here, there's multiple images you can find online in the image catalog showing exactly what I'm talking about, where you can clearly see in the visors of these astronauts the other astronauts taking the photographs, and they are 100% facing the area that they're trying to take a picture of. Here's a shot from one of the most famous Apollo images taken on the moon. And again, you can clearly see the astronaut who's taking the photo has got his whole body 100% facing the direction of the photograph, because that's the only way he can take it. He's not turned at an angle, he's not, you know, tilted sideways, because any deviation, you turn your body a little bit to the left or the right, and suddenly you're taking photos of an entire different part of the moon, and the astronaut isn't going to be in the shot. And that's what's so strange to me about this photograph, is that it would appear that this astronaut is, I mean, he's damn near completely looking and facing his body away from the guy he's taking a photo of. And I just don't understand how he is able to capture this photo when he is obviously not standing head on. And it looks as if he's looking at this large rock over here and is not even focused on taking a photo. You can see his arms dangling down to his side, so it doesn't even look like his hand is actually on the camera to take the picture. You can look at his legs and see that they're pointed away from the astronaut he's photographing. So yeah, that is my question. It's not so much the backpack, but how is he taking this photograph standing, facing away almost, from this astronaut? With this camera securely attached, it just doesn't make sense. You guys tell me what you think. It could just be simple distortion, but I think the image is pretty clear that this astronaut is not head-on. Despite distortion, distortion cannot change the position that a man is standing or rotate his body. So, yeah. Now, another, and I think in my opinion, a more intriguing set of photographs taken during the moon landing, which have kind of baffled me for years now, is another set of, again, photographs where something strange was discovered in the visor of one of the astronauts. And what many have said looks like some sort of stage light, which again would go back to the theory that the moon landing was hoaxed, and that it was just a big moon set, and there were lights hanging from the ceiling, and, you know, you're in a big Hollywood set. And this photograph has been a source of tension, because many people say this demonstrates that there was something large that looks like a studio light or apparatus of some sort hanging from the ceiling, and it was actually captured in several photographs in the astronaut's visor. So this occurred during the Apollo 12 mission. And so you're seeing the first image here. We see the astronaut walking on the moon. But if you look above them in the darkness of the supposed lunar sky, we see a very strange, an anomalous structure that appears to be hanging from the ceiling. And again, is what has been pointed out to look like a ceiling fan shaped object or a studio light. Others have said that this is possibly some sort of alien structure that was seen momentarily passing by or hovering in the sky, and the astronauts just didn't see it. But, I mean, as you guys are seeing in this first photo, it definitely does look like there's something there, hanging down from the ceiling. And likewise, when you go to the next photograph in sequence, we once again see this same object in the visor. You can clearly see this sort of strange object hanging from above that looks to have these arms protruding from it. And, you know, the shape of it, there was nothing on the moon. They, in all of their equipment, their landing gear, nothing looked like this. And they certainly didn't have anything that would have been hanging from anywhere. And so people are, you know, for years now have been struggling to figure out what could have caused this reflection in multiple photos. Which, under, you know, some enhancement, I have to say, does sort of look like a, you know, like what you would think of a stage light, or just something hanging from a ceiling that shouldn't exist if they were really on the moon. Now, lastly, we have the third photograph in this sequence, where once again, we see this same object hanging from the ceiling, along with what appears to be a strange white dotted structure of some sort. Now, this may be some sort of distortion or reflection from the sun, but either way, we can still see this object hanging from something with, again, these arms coming from it. Some have shown in these photographs what appears to be the shadow of this object being cast down on the moon's surface. And so that, to me, has been a much more intriguing and baffling photo when we're talking about reflections in visors taken during the moon landings. And it's been studied by thousands of people. So, as always, you guys tell me what you think. You know, now me personally, I do not believe that the moon landings were faked. Originally, when I first started the channel, I posted a lot of videos talking about, you know, the moon landing being hoaxed, and I was a firm believer. But the more I studied it, the more I found, and when you actually look into all of the different moon landings, and the thousands upon thousands of photographs taken, and the hundreds of hours of video and film footage taken not only on the moon, but while they were orbiting it and leaving it, it becomes apparent that we went to the moon. Now, what I will say and concede to is that they did, in fact, likely have to fake or stage certain photographs and pieces of footage to hide what was actually there. So I do believe we went to the moon, and that there were parts of the moon that they could not show us, things that they discovered there, and so they had to recreate those videos and photos, likely in a stage here on Earth, in order to conceal what was truly there. And in my opinion, that is what the evidence shows, more than just, well, the whole thing was hoaxed. So with that, thank you guys for stopping by. Let me know what you think. Check out the photographs for yourselves and stay tuned, because I've got much more coming, new videos in the works, and I will see you all back in just a bit.